gotta touch earth.
Cheesing off the high octane right now.
Hey, Muni, you up?
I'm here, ya.
Quick touch! One cradle movement! One cradle movement! Yeah, no!
From Roanoke after the timeout, down to 12 seconds. Loose ball. Hadley's going to scrap after it. It's a real fight. Couple players on the ground. Lynchburg will come out of there. Lynchburg will get the victory. Hard fought in every sense of the phrase. Hornets take down the Maroons 12-10 in a game that saw everything. Lynchburg has earned the right.
Last year was a little disappointing. I think we had all the pieces to the puzzle, but you know, we didn't execute everything to the highest level. We had a few tight games against some good teams, but throughout the game we came up for a breath, and you can't come gasping for air when it's a one goal game with a minute and a half left. It's just something the good teams don't do.
We had some bad losses in there. Didn't beat the teams I wanted to beat, so.
We've definitely like let ourselves down for the 3 years that I've been here, and each year it's just such a disappointment. Being a top team in the ODAC for this long, you know, it's you're expected to win, and when you lose, it's definitely like a heartbreak. And you know, playing in the ODAC, any ODAC game against a top team, it's like it's a Super Bowl, you know, it's a championship, even if it's regular season.
I think it was just the first half of the year was a big learning year for everybody. Like,
we were coming together still as a team, but as the year went on and the older guys stepped into their roles and the younger guys filled their roles, things came together and we understood what we could do as a team.
There's two good players and we all worked too hard to come out with the result we had last year.
There's still some goals that we have left that we haven't achieved yet, so that's kind of our main goal this year is going into these games we haven't beat yet. It's all about winning.
But I think it's good for our development that we did have one of those years after, you know, being in the NCAA tournament, because it's like, all right, guys, you can't just walk in and expect to repeat that every single time. While you might get better, so does everyone else.
Yo, Leonard hit it on the head, right? I feel like everyone was flying around. The intensity was, we were having fun. The intensity was good, but we're chugging out of bounds. So just keep in mind, like, there's one less day in your college career, right? All you seniors, this is their last fall ball. One less day of your last fall ball. One day closer to your last maroon and white game. All these things that we love so much. So keep that in mind and keep going hard.
Right, that's, I'm the fourth person to say it. Sticks were fucking shitty today, right? That's not an excuse. You can be bad at dodging. You can be bad at, you know, whatever you want in the day. Sticks are not an excuse. Everyone should have perfect fucking sticks. We're all college lacrosse players. Drop passes and drop balls are not an excuse, right? That's not an option. Other than that, I like the intensity today. That shit should be contagious. Everyone should get more fired up, more everyone else to get fired up, right? Good job today, keep bringing the intensity. Together on three, 1, 2, 3, together!
Quinn! Good.
Axe, pull! Axe!
You got one out.
One more, Dale, one more.
Drift, Casey. Too hot.
Big Joe, big crazy Joe.
Body, body.
Find it.
Hard, no, 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 no.
Go, hold on. Go.
Alright, fellas, listen, we gotta go over the difference.
Difference
is the chaos lacrosse system. The system we like to use, you gotta know it. Chaos stands for constantly harass and create opportunities to score. I would be using this system that I invented since 1992.
Patented.
Yeah, I should have.
Trademark.
Everybody's good. It's a tough conference to be in. It's kind of like the SEC of D3.
I think the biggest challenge is having back-to-back-to-back big competitive ODAC games. I think it can be tough on a team, especially when essentially you're guaranteed every season to have three or four games in a row that you know are going to be a dogfight, and you know everyone's got to come correct and everyone's got to play their best if you want to win that game. But it's the most fun, obviously. Like, what else would you not want to play in the most competitive conference?
Tough conference, man. Obviously, Division III has the showcase of a lot that there's not much of a difference from the top end D3 guys and even some of the D1s, D2s, stuff like that. You're playing against high level guys all the time, all across the conference. It's just not as exposed because it's not your Syracuse's, your UNC's, et cetera, et cetera. It's a gauntlet in the conference. You got to play a lot of teams in the conference, and I think the conference also does a really good job of playing really high level competition outside of the conference. There's no gimmicks. There's no easy road to the top kind of thing, and it's a fun conference to play in because it's tough.
What do you mean, snap?
Well, the
next. Like, snap.
Nice.
Oh, I know, yeah.
Oh, let them feel. I'll tell you, you're good. You're going.
Every single rep so far has been this. I throw to Wyatt, and he starts immediately going.
Being a fifth year now, it's kind of just had that bad taste in my mouth for too long, Just kind of like spin that bad taste over and over again. We're all tired of it. I think when I speak for the team when I say that, I think that coming into this season, pretty much got all our starters back. Some great freshmen who I'm excited to see what they got. I'm excited to see what they can contribute. I'm super excited for this year. I think that the mentality's definitely ramped up. Like I said, it's just we've had that bad taste in our mouth for too long. It's I think the whole team feels it. It's kind of time to really get in gear here.
That's kind of the culture. Grind, wake up, grind again.
Really just trying to hammer in this fall so that the spring can be starting at a peak rather than having to climb to the peak.
So on our off days, just going out, grabbing a buddy and shooting. Getting better every single day. And when you're practicing in the fall for 2.5 hours, just taking it quarter by quarter. And just getting everything you can every single day. We've all been playing together for 3 years now, going on 4. I think the chemistry there, the talent's always been there. We just got to bring everyone along and take it day by day, practice by practice, and don't look too far ahead. Go game by game and make sure we just go out and play our best every single day. And hopefully the time Memorial Day rolls around will be where we want to be.
All the kids that we needed to step up last year are veterans now. Sophomores are veterans. And at this point, on paper, we look like it's ODAC or bust. We look like we can be the best. All we have to do is pick up right where we left off from last year.
Paper and projections is one thing, results are another. And frankly, Coach Matt and I care more about results. Anyone can beat anybody. At the end of the day, it's what happens in the 60 minutes between the white lines. And you have 17 opportunities to showcase who you are and what you are. You just gotta go do it.
And our 6-year-old, let's do more wall ball. And like in my group, you were talking about how we need to do more shooting, not as much 6-on-6. That's just our group. I mean, I don't know what you guys are doing, but I saw the 6 weren't that good, so we got to pick that up. Tonight, have fun, be smart.
Get out there, boys. 1, 2, 3.
Yes.
I'm competitive. Coach Pyle's competitive. That's one thing you can't say about us is that we're not. And I think the majority, if not all, people that are in athletics are competitive people. If you don't have a competitive mindset, then you're going to fail in athletics. I just want those guys to have the experience, but more so just the sense of success over all the hard work that they have put in since I've gotten to see them as as their coach. You know, there's only one person in our program right now that has those stories, and it's Coach Pilot. And I want more people to have those stories. I want more guys to look up to the guys that are in our locker room like I looked up to the guys when I got to watch play. I still carry the pride of being a part of this program, and I want these guys to make their own history.
All the way through. Go, finish, finish. Stay with it.
Greg!
Jump, jump! J-Mo, because you're soft!
Yeah!
Let it be known, that is the cut.
Woo!
No more!
Sloppy!
I'm always gonna make a pass, either to my right or my left. If he makes it to the left, I'm gonna open up inside, throw my stick to the middle, all right, and you're gonna throw it across.
Even.
Now one. Get in.
Get him out of there. Good, run. Good, outside, good.
That guy looks like he's going behind me. Don't overextend too far, right? Let him go.
Charge out long now.
All right, Minnie's head down there. Minnie's head down there.
As far as short-term goals right now, I just get better every day. I think that we have to keep that same mentality. An ODAC championship every single day of practice, and the more you can do that, the string together with good games, and you look
up. I'm feeling confident. I mean, we've got a lot of returners, a lot of guys who went back home over the summer and really went to work, and everybody wants it, so I'm very confident about the year.
We have more weapons this year. Got older guys, a bunch of freshmen that played last year that are returning. I think this year we can really pull together and, you know, do some things that we've been wanting to happen. You know, we want to win an ODAC championship, but I think now we really know that we're top of the line and we can do that.
I think our team's so confident this year. Every guy thinks they're the best player on the team, best player on the field at all times, and that's what we need to win games. Every guy thinking they're the best.
I think that, you know, it's well known. I think it's one of the best conferences in the entire country. I think that, you know, pretty much any team would say that, any player. Lynchburg, WNL, Hampton, Sydney, Roanoke are, you know, very historic, well-known teams. So anyone in the country, when they sign up to play an ODAC team, is going to play their best game. You know, one of Pilot's mottos is that whenever you play Roanoke, they're going to have their best game. So, you know, as a team at Roanoke, we know that coming into every game, it's going to take our best. No team is going to back down. They all want to be the ODAC team. So that we take that with pride, and we honestly embrace it.
They all come out here to win. They're coming out here to beat Roanoke College. We got a target on our back playing here, but like I said, we want that. We want those teams to not like us. We want to beat them while they hate us.
We just know that they're coming for blood every game. We have Roanoke on our chest, and nobody takes that lightly. You know, we have a prestigious history, and every other coach in the ODAC knows that, and they want to take us down. But it's the best thing possible playing here, because everybody hates it, but we hate everybody too.
Really, the only thing that's going to be different is we're going to fucking win this year. That's all I got to say.